Okay, perfect. So today we are going to discuss string, okay, in great detail. I will disclose the, you know, the associated method which are related to that string. The string is one of the powerful data type in any of the programming language, and it is highly used. It's a highly used data type. So without string, it's very difficult to make the programs, to make the projects, because whenever you're fetching the data from somewhere, let's suppose you're fetching the data from the files or from some other data sources, at that time the 90% chances are the data will become in the form of the string. Okay, so whenever you get the data in the form of the string, according to your requirement, you are supposed to convert it. Okay, the best feature of a string, it support any special character, it support all the characters even. Okay, for example, sometime the data can be something like this. Yes, it support, because inside string, as we already seen, you can do anything, anything is acceptable. Okay, so string is one of the more powerful data type in all programming language, not in the Python only. Whenever you're thinking about to making a projects or making a programs, at that time the string is highly used. Okay, so inside Python, I am giving you the quick refresh about this thing, whatever till now we studied about this thing, the very basics about this thing. Okay, so this one is a string, as I already discussed into the previous videos as well. You can define a string with double quote, you can define a string with single quote. Okay, that doesn't matter. So in the both of the cases, it will be considered as a string in the case of the Python. So choice is again your, if you're comfortable with single quote, you can proceed the string with single quote. If you're comfortable with double quotes, then you can proceed the into the double quotes. Okay, so the another thing is, whenever you are defining something like this, okay, starting the string with triple single quotes, and it is highly recommended that you should close the string with triple double quotes. If you're starting the string with triple single quotes, then it is highly required to close the string with triple single quotes, otherwise you will get the error message, invalid syntax, something like this. And this triple, you know, this triple quotes support the multi-line strings. Okay, for example, you want to define something like this, hello Ravi, okay, and then Python, something like this. You want to define a string into the multiple lines, at that time this triple quotes will help you. And whenever you want to, you know, comment inside the coding, okay, comments, I think you guys are understand how we can make the comments. If you are coming from the C++ background, at that time you guys use this slashes. Okay, so same here, if you want to make a single line comment, then you are supposed to use hash. Now what exactly comment is? The comment mean that is not relevant to your logic. This is just for the information, nothing else. Let's suppose prior to making a program, you're writing the name of the program, write a program, okay, write a program for, let's suppose, binary conversion, something like this. Okay, you want to just give, you want to print it just for an information. So if you want to do this activity, at that time the Python supports this hash. Okay, with the help of this hash, you are supposed to make a comment into that programs. Okay, this is just for the information method, nothing else. Okay, and another way, I want a multi-line comment. Okay, this time I want a multi-line comment. So making a multi-line comment, that again the same thing that you are supposed to use. You are supposed to open the string with triple single quotes, and you are supposed to close, if you are opening the string with triple single quote, it is mandatory to closing the string with triple single quotes. Otherwise, the same scenario, whenever you are opening a string with triple double quotes, make sure you are closing the string with triple double quotes. And yes, it supports the multi-line commands. For example, write a program for let's suppose add of two numbers, just like this. You want to give information on the screen, similar to like this. Okay, so choice is again your. And this is very basic about this thing. Now again, the next concept, that the slicing. Yes, we know it very well. The slicing is a concept by which you can fetch out the required string. If you want to do a single slicing, it's very simple. You have to pass the index of that character. Okay, index of that character. Now, whenever you pass the index of that character, you will get the character that is present on this index. For in this case, if I do the slicing, I'll get the output that is the H. Okay, this is the single slice character, single character slicing. Let's suppose you want to make a multiple, you know, the multiple character slicing. So for the same, what you have to do, x 1 colon, and let's suppose 4. So it's mean that it is up to 4, not including 4. You are starting from 1 and you are supposed to move to the third, okay, third index. But the fourth index is not inside your boundary. You always think it's work like a n minus 1. So n is this one, your last limit, this one, okay. You can ask the dynamically from the user. So you can simply pass the n value over here. Yes, it will work fine, but make sure n should be the integer type. If you pass over here string type, list type, you will get the error. Okay, for example, 9. So it's mean I am doing the slicing from 1 to 8. Okay, that's mean up to 9, not including this 9. You can take something like this. Again, the third parameter is called stepping. By default, if I give or not give, the slicing is incrementing of the 1. The stepping is incrementing of the 1. But I want to explicitly change the stepping, that I don't want the stepping of 1. Then what I can use, I can pass my own stepping. Okay, now it will take the jump of 2. Basically, the concept of the stepping is, now it's taking a jump of 2. I am standing over here, and after that, by default, the stepping is 1. But this time, I explicitly change the stepping. So I am supposed to take the jump of 2. I am standing on the first position, then I took a jump of 2, then I will reach on the 3. Again, I am supposed to take the jump of 2, then I will reach on the 5. Okay, after that I will reach on the 7, then 9, then 11, and so on. Okay, so this one is very basics that we already discussed into the previous sections as well. I just give you the quick refresh for the same. Okay, so I want to do the iteration. Okay, I want to do the iteration with this string. So let's suppose this one is my string, x contain anything, let's suppose the hello again. So I want to do the iteration with it. The first way, very simple way, 4i in x. And what you can do, you just simply print, okay, with the help of this tab indentation, you simply print of i. This is the one way to do the iteration. Okay, one way to process the every element on this string. Okay, iterating or processing the every element on this string. So this is the one way. Second way, we already seen with the help of len method. Okay, len method is also available with this, with string, with list, with tuple, okay, with dictionary as well. So, for example, now if I print len of x, okay, len of x. Now what output I will get? I will get the output, the counting of this string, and keep this point into the mind. Whenever you are using a len function, okay, len function, basically these are the function, okay, sometime by mistakenly I say the methods. I will explain you later on what exactly difference between the function and the methods. Okay, later on I will explain, but there is no much difference. So you can say it as a function or you can say it as a method, but this one is a specifically the function. Why it's a function, I will tell you today, don't worry. So the another way with the help of the len, you know, this len function. So len mean it's returning me the length of this x, and x contain this hello, and by default length is always start from 1. That's mean what output you will get? 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, I will get the, that is the 5. That's it. Okay, this is the one way iteration. This is the one way of the iteration. Now I am showing you the another way of the iteration that we already seen in the case of the printing of that pattern. Whenever we print the pattern of the prime numbers, at that time we've seen this concept. The same thing I'm using over here, for I in, okay, range of len of this x. So how, what value over here? Here the value become 5. So that's mean this loop is iterate through from 0 to 4, okay, not including 5, 0 to 4, okay, then colon. Then what you have to do, you have to perform the concept of the slicing. Very simple, x of i, that's it. Now the first value of the I is 0. Now x of 0 you will get h. Now again the I value become 1, then the x of 1 you will get e, and so on, l and o. These are the all things that we already seen into the previous section. This is just quick refresh for the same. Now I am moving to the next concept, basically the methods. Okay, now this time the methods which are associated with this thing. So prior to move that method, okay, let me recap the same thing, the concept of the concatenation. Let's suppose this one is a hello and you want to do the concatenation. Okay, concatenation. Now if you want to do the concatenation, then again you have to use the help of this plus operator. So whenever you perform x plus y, okay, whenever you perform x plus y, then the output would be become hello Ravi. Okay, hello Ravi. No, it won't get any spaces. Okay, So this will output you will get. This is the concept of the concatenation. The concept, basically the concept of the polymorphism, ability to take then one or the more form. So X plus Y mean the hello Ravi. Now you are getting the concatenated output. So same thing, the multiplication again, if you want to do the multiplication, X multiply by 2. Okay, now what output you will get? You will get again hello. Okay, two times hello. Okay, so these are the just the recap things that we already discussed in great detail in the previous of the sections. Now I am moving to the next concepts that are available into this string. Okay, so let's suppose the in function. Okay, in function, hello I am Python. Okay, hello I am Python. So inside this, let's suppose I want to check it out. Okay, I want to check it out whether h is available or not. Okay, whether h is available or not, h in x, then the output would be true. Okay, the in operator, the output would be true, because this is highly used operator inside the strings cases. When this operator is available inside the list, inside the tuple, inside the set, inside the dictionary as well. Okay, and this is highly usable operator. Okay, the in operator is highly usable operator. So h in x, yes, the output would be true. Okay, you will get the output. That output is a true output. Why so? Because I am saying h in x, yes, the output will, you will get the output that is the true. Okay, so next is the comparison of these things. Okay, comparison operator, the same comparison operator, less than. Okay, then you can perform the greater than. Okay, and you are supposed to perform the double equals to. These are the comparison operators which are available in the case of the strings as well. So for example, I am taking two string s1. okay, I am taking one string, that is the s1, let's suppose any name Ram. Okay, and s2, that is again let's suppose the Mohan. Okay, now Mohan. So I want to check it out. Okay, so let me take a small names over here, Am and Bohum. Okay, so why I use these names? Because I have to explain the concept of this. So the first thing is that is starting with A, the second string is that is starting with B. Okay, so I want to check it out which one is, you know, which one is the greater. Okay, which one is the greater. So how I can check it out? How I can check it out? So for checking the same thing, S, if, okay, I am making a very small program. If, okay, if s1 double equals to s2, then what I am saying, print both of strings are same. Okay, both are same. The second case, alif, okay, alif s1 greater than s2 s1, okay, s1 greater than s2, then what you have to print of s1 is greater. Okay, s1 is greater. Okay, the next case, else, what you can say, the print of s2 is greater. Okay, s2 is greater. So this is a concept. Okay, this is the comparison of this thing. Now in the first case that I am saying, if both of these things are same mean both are containing the same value. The comparison of this thing that we already discussed, the equality operators. Okay, if the both of the strings are same, then output would be get the both are the same. But in this case, this string is not equals to s2. Okay, that's mean arm is not equal to bohon. Okay, so that's why your first scenario is failed. Your first scenario is failed. Now it will move to the second one. Now at this time I'm saying s1 is greater than s2. Yes, s1 is greater than s2. Why I'm saying it? Because here the comparison is not made on the length. Keep this point into the mind. The comparison doesn't mean that the comparison of the length. So here the comparison of the first character, okay, the comparison of the first character, A is greater than B. Okay, A is greater than B. So that's why you will get the output that is A is greater. Okay, let me just check this scenario, which one is taking greater, A or B. Let me check. So here this one, when it do the comparison of this one, I am saying s1 is greater than s2. No, s1 is not greater than s2, because the b value is greater, as we already discussed in the last section. The b Unicode character is 67. Okay, so this condition is again failed. Then when this condition is failed, then your else part would be executed. It will display the message on the screen, s2 is greater. So keep this point into the mind. Here the comparison is not made over the length. The comparison is made on the first character. okay, the comparison is made on the first character. So in this case, it will comparison of the first character. Let's suppose, now observe this scenario. The first characters are same in the both of the cases. Then what will happen? Now it will check the second character. Okay, it will check the second character. So keep this point into the mind. The comparison is based on the second character. Okay, so this one is the funda in the case of the, you know, the relational operator when you are going to implement over the strings. So always comparison of the first character. Keep this point into the mind. Here the comparison note for the length, but you want to do the comparison over the length, very simple, you can check it out. You can just simply use this len function. If the len of s1 double equals to len of s2, now this one is the comparison, okay, the comparison between the length of the strings. So here the length is not greater, they're not equals to, then you are getting the output on the screen. Okay, this is not equal, then it will go over here. Now again this condition is again false, then it will go over here, the s2 is greater if I comparison again in the cases of the length. So keep this funda into the mind. When you are using a comparison operator or the relational operators on these things at that time, what is happening, what is happening, it is the comparison of the characters. Okay, it is the comparison of characters, the Unicode values of that character, that is the order of A, as we already discussed, the order of A and order of B, something like this. So this is very simple funda that you are supposed to use this relational operator on these things as well. So the next is, now the next is the various, you know, the various methods, okay, the methods which are associated with this thing, the methods, okay, methods. Okay, these are the methods which are associated with this thing. So the method which I am showing you, which are the various method which are associated with this thing. Now we already discussed what is this thing. Now why I am saying this time the methods? So keep this point into the mind. This is very, you know, the diplomatic question inside the interview room. What is the difference between function and what is the difference between method? Okay, when we say the method, when we say the function. Okay, so earlier that we saw a function, that is the len. Okay, len. So this one is a function. Okay, this one is a function. But when I will use with the help of dot operator, okay, whenever I will use any method with the help of dot operator, at that time that would be considered as a method, because that is inside that class. So here, as we know very well, the string is a class. Now I am gonna to explain the method which are associated into that class. Okay, so later on we will understand this thing into the great detail. For this point of time, just keep this point into the mind. Whenever someone going to ask you what is the difference between function and what is the difference between method, the function which is available independently, okay, and the method mean that this one is the method which is associated with that appropriate class. So here I am going to disclose the methods of this thing. The method of these things mean the methods, the basically these are again like a function, don't worry about it, exactly the concept is same. But this time, these are the function, we can say something like this. These are the function who are just implemented with the strings only. Okay, who are just implemented with the strings only. They are called the methods of this thing. Okay, they are called the method of this thing. So keep this point into the mind. Later on, we will describe how we can define our function and how we can convert them into the methods. Okay, so kindly remove this confusion inside your mind. Whenever you are using the concept of the method and whenever you are using the concept of the function, the terminology is same, the working methodology is same, okay, but the conceptual names are different. Okay, so I think this concept is clear in great detail. So here I am going to define the method which are associated with this thing, and keep this point, method always implemented with the help of this dot. So the first method that I am going to explain with you guys that is associated. Yeah, please. Please, sure.
Function can be used in class.
No. The function are independently available. Okay. And the methods, the that function, let's suppose I am putting that function into some separate unit. And that unit is a class. So at that time, that function become the method. This is the only difference, nothing else.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So this is the concept.
Yeah.
So, Just similarly like to this, whenever you go into the kitchen, there is one Almira, and that Almira, you put out the all the electronics component into that Almira. Okay, for example, your grinder, your mixing, your coffee machine. Now you are saying it, now you are saying, okay, this one is Almira, and inside that Almira, you will find out all the electronics product which are used into the kitchen. Okay, electronics and electrical product. Now that time, that Almira become a class, and inside that class, the functionality what you place there, for example, your electric kettle, for example, your coffee machine, now that they become the function, they become the method, okay, they become the method. So this is these concepts, you can consider this concept something like this. So always the basic terminology to keep these things remember, whenever you are using the method, then you have to implement with the help of dot. On which class that method is, the string class, that means that object should be from the string class. For example, the S is a string over here. Now I want to perform the methods of which are related to this string, then S dot this. Okay, so this one is the basic terminology. Now I am associating, I am showing you what are the various methods which are available to this string class. Okay, so first method, removing the spaces of the string. For example, your string is this one. At the starting of string, you are getting spaces. At the end of string, that you are getting spaces. Now my question is, I am getting a string from somewhere, and in that string I am getting spaces whenever the string is going to start and after end of this string. My question is, sir, I want to remove these spaces. Okay, I want to remove these spaces. For very beautiful method is there, with the help of that method you can remove these spaces, and that method is called s dot, okay, s dot r strip, okay, strip, okay, r strip. Now this one is a method. So r strip mean it will remove the spaces which are on the right hand side, okay, which are on the right hand side. Only remove the spaces which are available on the right hand side. So this one method, let's suppose you want to remove the spaces which are available on the left hand side. So how you can remove it? Control C, Control V. So s dot l strip, perfect. Okay, s dot l strip. Now sir, my requirement is, I want to remove the spaces, both of the spaces, it doesn't matter, the spaces are on the left hand side, the spaces are on the right hand side. So for the same, the method is called strip. That's it. These are the three methods which are used to remove the spaces from a string. Now show the practical usage, then the picture would be more clear. So let's suppose this one is my string. At the left hand side I am getting spaces, on the right hand side I am getting spaces. Now my question is, sir, I want to remove the spaces that are available on the right hand side. S dot r strip. Now you will get the output. The spaces that are available in the right hand side are resolved out. Okay, again the same thing for the left hand side. For the left hand side you have to perform the L space. Okay sir, but my requirement is that I want to remove the spaces which are available on the both of the sides. So very good, no, don't worry, the method is called strip method. Okay, the method is called strip method. So I am getting all this. Okay, so this is the first method which I shows you to removing these spaces. Okay, so the next method is,
sir,
please,
length function
hai,
right?
Sir, that is the function.
That's function.
Yeah.
Aapne bataya ye r strip ya l strip jo bhi hain, they are the methods. Ye dot se chalte hain. और तीसरी चीज मैं आपको कल वाली क्लास में वापस ले जाना चाहता हूँ. रिमेम्बर हम लोग बात कर रहे थे सिर्फ स्लीप, हमने टाइम का यूज किया था. तो उसमें आपने शुरू में कुछ एक लाइन ऐड करी थी, आई फॉरगॉट द
इंपोर्ट
स्टार्टिंग ऑफ, आपने कुछ ऐड इंपोर्ट. इसमें भी तो हमने टाइम डॉट लगा के यूज किया
था. यस सर. ओके, so sir, understand the concept, because inside Python the functional approach is very, you know, the very strong approach. Okay, so here what exactly the difference between module and what is the difference between class. So module is a unit, is a file where I place all the function. Okay, I place all the function, that is called module. So time is a module where I place all the function which are relevant to the, you know, with the relevant to the time. So here the S is a class. Okay, here the S is a class. If I type it, type of S, then you will get a class of str. Now these are the methods these are the methods which are available only with the string. For example, this len method, okay, for example, sorry, this len function. So this len function is available with the string. This len function is available as well as with, you know, with this list, okay, with this list. But with list, I am not supposed to use the function that method is called rstrip or lstrip. When I perform this rstrip with this, now you will get the error message. Okay, now you will get the error message. List object has no attribute rstrip. Because this is the concept, this is the method which is associated only with the string. And this len is a function which is associated to everyone. I think now the picture is more clear. So the string, the strip function, okay, I design a strip function and I design specifically for the string class. So I putting this function into that string class because this is the functionality only for the string only. Okay, so, and I want to segregate it. So for segregating it, what I am doing, I am putting this method, basically this function into that string class. Now it become a method of that string class. I think now the picture is more clear. I design a function. Now I design a function only for this thing. Okay, I design a function only for this thing. I segregating it from the entire of the data structure inside the Python. I want it, the person who are gonna to use this strip, the object should be string type. Now what I am doing, I am putting this function into specific class and that class is called string. And after putting that function inside that class, now that function become the method of that class. That's it. This is the only difference between the function and the method. Whenever I put, let's suppose I put this len function inside some of the class, then this len function will become the method of that class. That is the only difference. Okay, because I am associating it. I am saying it lstrip is only available for the string class. That's why I am segregating it. Okay, you are the only supposed to use with this string class. So I am giving you the permission only whenever the person hit the help of the dot and write the name of that associated method which is available into that class. So here the concept is the importing a module. So here I have different, you know, the different function, and after that function I am putting them into a one file and that file is called module. Later on we will understand this concept, because inside your curriculum, the core Python, I will describe this thing into the great detail, how you can define your own modules, okay, and how you can put out the functions into that module and how you are supposed to use them, because there are various ways to use them. Okay, there is only not a single way, import time, only not a single way. You can import these kind of things with the help of different terminology. Later on, we will understand each and everything into the great detail. So for this point of time, just keep this point into the mind. Whenever you are going to use lstrip, rstrip or strip, the object should be string. With the list or with the dictionary, if you try to use it, then you will get the error message something like this, that the list object has no attribute strip. Okay, I hope you get the clarity of this concept. I think, any question?
No, there is no question. I got it clearly. Like, len is a function which can be used anywhere. As far as the strip is concerned, that's only applied to the string functions. It's you know, closed entity, it's not available everywhere.
Yes.
Baki the time overhang, like, they can be applied anywhere, but as long as you import them in the beginning of the program.
Yes. Okay. So the strip is a method which is available. Now the next is the find and index. Okay, find and index. Okay, the another method is find and index. Let's suppose I am writing this. I love Python. Okay, now I am writing the indexes number for the same. Okay, for example, let's me for the more clarity. Okay, so don't fill it, there is space. Okay, don't fill it, for just writing the index number for the same, that's I am making a spaces over there. So there is, let's suppose there is no space, keep this point into mind. Okay, there is space only here after I. Okay, and after where the space is there, I am putting two tabs. Okay, I am putting two tabs. So now the picture would be more clear. Okay, so this one is the index of 0. Okay, this one is the index of 0. Okay, the space is also containing index. Okay, let's suppose the space here, the index of 1. A अगेन एल ऑन टू थ्री फोर फाइव एंड देन अगेन वी हैव स्पेस स्पेस ऑल्सो कंटेन इंडेक्स ओके सो देर इज वन स्पेस सो आई एम पुटिंग सिक्स देन सेवन एट नाइन ओके टेन इलेवन ओके सो सेवन एट नाइन टेन इलेवन ट्वेल्व सो आई थिंक यू गाइज क्लियर आई एम राइटिंग द इंडेक्सिंग ऑफ द ऑल द थिंग्स ओके सो मेक इट मोर क्लैरिटी आई एम जस्ट डूइंग इट because I don't have pen and pad and it's very difficult so understand this so here the my characters are on these indexes okay this is my and the complete string I love python okay and I is available on the zero index space is available on the one index okay then l is available on the two index l is available on the two index and so on okay and so on the o is available on the three index the v is available on the fourth index okay and the e is available on the fifth index then we have a space okay then we have a space on the sixth index so understand this concept so I elaborated it just like a according to the index numbers so my question is I have to implement these two methods the one method is find and the second one method is the index the find method automatically name specify itself it is returning you whatever you want to find okay and the same thing the index method exactly same it will return you the index number of that particular character or string whatever you want to find it out from the entire string so now how we can use it understand this concept so this one is my entire string I love python so this one is the complete string now what I want to find so let's suppose x dot find of okay x dot find of what I want to find out l okay I want to find out the l so what output I will get What output I will get? I will get the index number 2. Perfect. Okay, I will get the index number 2. Same over here. When I write x dot index of that, I want to find out the index of l. Okay, so output would be again the output would be again that is the 2 because l is present on the 2 index perfectly. Let's suppose I write it x dot find of this Python. Okay, this Python. So this Python now I will get the output. The starting index of the Python is 7. So I will get the output that is the 7. Okay. Now again I write the same thing over here. X dot index of. Let's suppose again the Python. Okay. Again the Python. Now again it will return me the same thing. The index, the starting index. It always return the starting index of this Python. Okay, and the starting index of this Python is 7. So after that, it is considering okay, the entire Python is there that I am returning you this 7. Okay, so again one more time. Now this time, as you can see, O is here. O is here. Okay, now I want to find it out the O. X dot find of O. Okay, X dot find of O. So output, the output would be, this one 3. Okay, it will return you the first occurrence of that character. Okay, it will not return you the entire rows. So keep this point into the mind. Same in the case of this. Here again, I write the terminology x dot index of. Okay, index of again this O. Okay, again this O. Now again, you are getting the output at exactly same 3. Okay, exactly same 3. Now observe this scenario. The both methods which are working as the same. Okay, the both method which are working is the same. Now, what is the difference between these two methods? Now, I'm showing you. Let's suppose I want to find it out. X dot find. Okay, find O, for example, this. Let's suppose I want to find it out P from where to where. Okay, now this time I want to find it out from third to tenth location. Yes, I can pass it out. So it will search only between this third to this tenth location. And here if it find p then immediately it will return you the index of that okay index of that perfectly same okay perfectly same now the same thing when I am going to implement over here okay going to implement over here rather than the find I am implementing the with this concept of the index now again same output would be same there is no difference till now okay output would be same now observe the next scenario so let's suppose this time I am writing over here find of this x okay find of this x from entire string or whatever where you want to find you can find it out now x is not available x is not available to entire of this thing now what output I will get the output that is the minus 1 keep this point into the mind whenever the string is not there whenever that character is not there okay whenever the string or character is not there at that time the find method gonna to return you minus one. The mean of the minus one is that element is not available for which you are looking for. Okay, or that character might be, that can be the character, might be that can be the string that is not available. So at that time you will get the output on the screen, that is the minus one. But the same thing I gonna to implement into this index. So what output I will get? So what output I will get? I'll show you right now. So for the same, whenever you going to implement the index method over here, okay, index method over here, then in this case you are getting the error message. That error message is the key error, or might be that can be the value error. Okay, so in this case you will get the error. Okay, in this case you will get the error. In this case you will get the minus one. It is again up to you. Okay, it is again up to you. The usage of the both are same. Okay, there is only one difference. Whenever the output is the, whenever the searching character or the string is not available, at that time it will return you minus one in the case of the find method. When you are using the same thing in the case of the index method, then you are gonna to get the error message. Okay, so let me show you practically, that will make more sense. So let me open the IDLE. Okay, IDLE. I don't know why not opening. Okay, so here the string is this one, I love Python. Okay, this one is the string, that is the I love Python. Now x dot find of, okay, I'm using find. What I want to find, I want to find it out I. Okay, I am getting the index of 0 because I is available on the 0. Okay, now I am writing Python. Now you will get the output, that is the 7, because that Python is available on the index of 7. Now I want to find it out the Python from 4 to 7. That's mean, or 5 to 7. That's mean the 5 to 7 index is the Python is not available. You are getting the output, that is the minus 1. Okay, same thing. Let's suppose for more, make it more clear. So here I am passing the x. Now you are getting again minus one because my x is not available to throughout this entire string. Then you are getting the output, that is the minus one. Okay, so same thing I am going to implement. Same thing I am going to implement with the help of the index method. So with the help of the index method, now you are getting the output again same, that is the 7. Okay, same thing I am going to implement with the index. Now again you will get the output, that is the index of 0. Okay, index of 0. Now the same thing I am going to implement with the index. Now you will find out the, what is the difference between the index and the find. Now you are getting the output, that is the value error. Okay, you are getting the output, that is the value error. The substring is not found. So this is the only difference. Whenever the output is not, the searching character is not there, then you will get the output, that is the minus one. If in the case of the index the character is not there or the string is not there, then you will get the output, that is the this one, the value error. Okay, choice is again here, what you want to use you can use, but always I will give the preference to this find, because in this case the chances of the errors are very less. But in this case, if the string is not there but you are searching for that string and you implemented the index method, that time you will get the error message and you have to, you know, handle that error. So this one is a concept. In the case of the find and the index method, I will give you one assignment for the same. And you are supposed to use that index method or find or index method into that. Whichever you feel comfortable, you can proceed with that. Okay, the next method is inside this. I already show you the R strip, L strip. Okay, and then strip, then find, then index. Okay, the next is the split method. Okay, the split, highly used, very useful method, that is the split. So understand this concept. What exactly the meaning of the split? So split means the English terminology to break down or to segregate. The same concept over use over here. Let's suppose I am writing a string, hello Python. Okay, I am writing a string, that is the hello Python. Now I want to split it out. Okay, on what basis that I want to split it out? Whenever the space is there. Okay, whenever the space is there, I want to split it. I want to break down according to that space. Let's suppose here is one more word, hello Python, I love. Okay, let's suppose this one is string. So I want to split this string. on what basis that I want to split? I want to split this string on the basis of the spaces. Whenever the spaces occur, at that time your string should be breaked out. So how I can perform this activity? Understand it. For same, we have a method. That method is called split. Okay, so x is l is equal to x dot split. Okay, split, that's it. Whenever you are empty these braces, okay, whenever you don't pass any argument into these braces, it automatically consider now I am going to break out this string whenever the spaces occur. Okay, whenever the spaces occur, so I am gonna to break out this string whenever the spaces occur. And by default the return type of split is list. So what output I am getting? So I will get the output in the form of the list. So L is a list. Okay, this L is a list which will contain the data. Okay, after splitting of this string, and the return type of this split is list. Observe my scenario. So what output I will get in the case of L? I will get the output L will become a list, and here on the first index you will get the hello. On the second index, that you will get the Python. Okay, Python. In the third index, what you will get? You will get the I. Okay, this one I, and what you will get into the next index, that is the love. So this one is the concept for the same. Whenever you perform the split will always return you data in the form of the list. So it the list is basis on what basis I created a list? I created a list on whenever the space is coming. So it will divide it into the list. So this one become a zero index, this one become a one index, this one become a two index. Okay, let me show you one more use case. Let's suppose this time a string is this one. Y, okay, y is equal to, for example, 22/10/2002. Okay, this one is a date that you want to split it out. On what basis that you want to split it out? Whenever the hyphen is occurred, that I want to split it out. Okay, so for the same, what I have to do? V is equal to y dot split of, on what basis I am gonna to split it? I am basing on the basis of this hyphen. So now this V become, okay, this V become a list. On the first index you will get 22, on the second index you will get 10, and in the third index you will get the 2002. So this one is a split method. Keep this point into the mind. Split always return you list. Okay, always return you list. And that split is a method who is implemented only with this thing. You are not supposed to perform this with the list, tuple, or any of the other. Okay, so I'll show you the practical uses, then the clarity will be more there. So let's suppose this one is my string that I love, okay, Python. Okay, I love Python. Now what I am doing? X dot split. Split, whenever I leave these braces empty, automatically it is splitting on the basis of the spaces. Okay, so again one more case is I am taking x is equal to 22/08/2002. Okay, the same 2002. Okay, whatever the date is there. Okay, so I want to split it out. X dot split. Okay, split on one what basis that I want to split? I want to split on the basis of the hashes. So now you will get the list. And this list, that list contain the element. On the zeroth index you will get this one, second, and third. Okay, so one more case is there. Let's suppose this time the string contain 22 #, okay, 33 #, 44 #, 55. Okay, this one is your string. Now you want to break this string, you want to split this string on the basis of hashes. Okay, so again you will get this output. Okay, this one is the funda. So I'll give you one assignment that is based on this split. Okay, so again the next is the join. The next method is called join. As the name specify it, join, I am joining something. Okay, I am joining something. Now what I am gonna to join? Okay, observe this scenario. So join is always implement. Okay, join is always implement with string, but it take a argument, it take a parameter. Here you give the parameter of this hyphen, but here the parameter, whatever parameter that you are passing, that parameter should be in the form of list only, and that list should be contain strings only. Keep this point into the mind. I am repeating my words again. The join is a method which is associated with the string, and the parameter, the argument, or you can say the parameter, or you can say the argument. The parameter or the argument which are going to pass into that join, that should be in the form of list. Okay, एंड डैट लिस्ट शुड बी कंटेन द डेटा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्ट्रिंग्स ओनली. ओके दैट शुड बी कंटेन द डेटा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्ट्रिंग्स ओनली. देन यू आर सपोज टू परफॉर्म दिस ज्वाइन. एंड ज्वाइन नेम स्पेसिफाई इट सेल्फ. आई एम गोइंग टू ज्वाइन समथिंग. आई एम गोइंग टू ज्वाइन समथिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेकिंग द सेम एग्जाम्पल. आई टुक दिस. ओके आई टुक दिस डेटा. ओके द वाई इज इक्वल टू. ओके द वाई इज इक्वल टू 22. ओके 10 एंड 2002. ओके 2002. आई टुक दिस डेटा. सो नाउ माई वन क्वेश्चन इज माई क्लाइंट वांट सर आई डोंट वांट दिस हाइफन. आई वांट दिस स्लैशेज ओवर हेयर. ओके आई वांट दिस स्लैशेज ओवर हेयर. दैट इज माई रिक्वायरमेंट सर. ओके डोंट वरी. यू वांट स्लैशेज ओवर हेयर. सो डोंट वरी. वट आई डिड फर्स्ट आई हैव टू सप्लिट दिस डेटा. तो आई सप्लिटेड इट इन टू विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस सप्लिट मेथड. ओके सप्लिट ऑन वट बेसिस दैट आई वॉन्ट टू सप्लिट. आई वॉन्ट टू सप्लिट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द स्लैश. And now what I will get in the case of LL, I will get a list and that list will contain the data that is 22 on the 0th index, 1 on the 10 index and 2002 on the 2 index. So LL will become a list. Now what you want to join? What you want to join? Sir, I want to join this hash, this slash. Okay, sir, that is my requirement. Okay, no worry at all. So I want to join this slash. Okay, now what you want to join? Sir, join on which you want to join, sir, this LL. Okay, so now what output I will get? The return type of this join is string. The return type of this split is list, and the return type of this join is a string. So now you will get the output in the form of the string. And now what I join into this string? I join this slash on this LL, and the LL is a list. And I already told you, you have to pass this list into this join. So what output you will get? You will get 22 slash 10 slash 2002. Now it become a string. So I'll show you practically, then the picture would be more clear. Okay, this join method. So this one is my string. I have a string. My client requirement is that instead of these these hyphens basically. Instead of these hyphens, what I want to join, I want to join the slash. Okay, sir, don't worry about it. I can do it. So now x dot split off. Okay, split off. On what basis that you want to split? Sir, I want to split on the basis of this slash, this hyphen, sorry. Okay, now what output I will get? I will get a list. Okay, I will get a list with the help of the split method. On the 0th index that I am getting 22, on the 1 index I am getting 10, and so on. So sir, my requirement is I get a string into this format, but I want to join the hashes over here. Okay, so join hash, what you have to do? This one, okay, dot, not hash, the slash. Okay, this one dot join. Okay, on where you want to join? You want to join on this LL. So you are getting this. So this one is a usage of the join method. Okay, the split will split it out and the join will join the data. On what basis that you want to join? Sir, I want to join this. If you want to join space, don't worry about it. You can join this space. There is no issue. Whatever that you want to join, just you have to pass over here. Okay, sorry. No JJ, that's a LL. Okay, that's a LL. Now you are getting the output in the form of this. Okay, sir, I want to join the hash. Okay, sir, I want to join this hash. Don't worry, you can join this hash. Sir, I want to join X. Don't worry, you can join this X. So choice is again your what you want to do, but make sure whenever you passing that list should be always contain the data in the form of this thing. As you can see, 22 is in the form of this thing, 10 is in the form of this thing. Whenever this data is not in the form of this thing, then you will get the error message. For example, 22, okay, 22, let's suppose 10 and then 222. Now if I pass this, because this entire data is in the form of the integer, and I pass over here, immediately you will get the error message. Okay, the sequence item 0 expected string instance int found. Okay, so you are not supposed to send the data which contain the data in the form of the integer. Okay, so always make sure whenever you are passing any parameter, any argument inside the join, at that time that should contain only list, none of other is available. Okay, so this one is a join. So important one, again the split and the join is highly used. Okay, so next one is count. Very simple method, name specify itself the count. For example, your string contain this one. okay, your string contain this one. Okay, now I want to count out how many s are there. Okay, then the method is count. What you want to count, sir? I want to count s. So you will get the output that count s is available inside this string on 15 time. Okay, inside this 15 time. So here, let's suppose you want to count again the another usage of this count. You want to count of this s from where to where, sir? I want to count it out from the index of 2 to index of 6. Now I want to check it out. How many s's are there from index of 2 up to index of 6? Okay, so how many s's are there? So the output is there is only one. Okay, there is only one. We can check it out because it's always n minus y, n minus 1. Okay, so index of 2, 3, 4, and 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you have only one s. Okay, you have only one s. So always keep this point into the mind. It is always run up to, not include. So this one is the base or the thumb rule inside the Python. Okay, so the next one is a replace. Okay, so I want to replace. So name specify itself. I want to replace. I want to replace this s with whom? Sir, I want to replace with s with z. Okay, so now the entire s, okay, now entire s has been replaced with z. Okay, with this z. So this one is the concept that replacing, how you can replace it. Okay, so again the next is the very, you know, the split we did it, join we did it, count we did it, replace we did it. Okay, yes, let's suppose I want to check it out. Okay, I want to check it out. Let's suppose this one is a string. Okay, I love Python. Now I want to check it out whether this string is start with, the string starts with, okay, with whom? With whom, sir? I want to check it out whether this string is start with I. The output is true, yes, because this string is starting with I. Okay, I want to check it out, is this string start with X? No, it's a false. That string doesn't start with X. Okay, so there is another method which is the opposite to this one, ends with. Okay, ends with. So I want to check it out whether this string ends with, okay, ends with N. The output would be true. Yes, this string is ends with N. I want to check it out whether this string ends with X. No, the output is false. Whether this string ends with Python. Okay, ends with Python. Yes, the output is true. That string is ends with Python. Okay, so you can check it out the single character, as well as you can check it out the entire string. Okay, so ends with, starts with, join, split, count, len, and your early one, the R strip, L strip. Okay, so these are the methods which are highly used. Okay, the next one is, let's suppose this one is a string. Very simple method, very useful and very easy to keep remember. So I want to convert this string into the uppercase. Okay, so method for the same is upper. Okay, s dot upper. Now everything converted into the uppercase. Okay, so let's suppose this one is a string. Now I want to convert it into the lowercase. Very simple. S dot lower, that's it. Now the string is converted into the lowercase. Now let's suppose this one is a string. Sum of character are into the capital letter. Sum of character are into the small letter. Okay, sum of the capital, sum of the small. Okay, so now what I want to do? I want to do the swapping. The which character are the character which are into the uppercase, I want to convert them into the lowercase. The character which are into the lowercase, that I have to convert them into the uppercase. So the concept for the same is s dot swap case. Okay, swap case. Now you will get the output that this one, the character which are starting with the uppercase, okay, the uppercase character become the lowercase, and the lowercase character become the uppercase. This concept is called swapping. Okay, so another one, the title. Let's suppose this is the Python. The Python is very easy. Okay, this one is my string. This one is my string. That what I want to do. I want to convert it into the title. Okay, I want to convert it into the title. Now what is happening? The every character, एवरी करेक्टर ऑफ द वर्ड, ओके, एवरी करेक्टर ऑफ द वर्ड स्टार्ट्स विद कैपिटल लेटर, ओके, द रेस्ट विल बिकम इन टू द स्मॉल लेटर्स ऑटोमेटिकली, ओके. सो दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज कॉल्ड टाइटल. सो द नेक्स्ट इज एस डॉट कैपिटलाइज, ओके, कैपिटलाइज, कैपिटलाइज, ओके. सो कैपिटलाइज, द मीनिंग ऑफ द कैपिटलाइज इज द फर्स्ट लेटर इज कैपिटल, द रेस्ट ऑफ लेटर बिकम स्मॉल, ओके, द रेस्ट ऑफ लेटर बिकम स्मॉल. सो दीज आर द फाइव, यू नो, द चेंजिंग केस ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग मेथड्स. सो हाईली यूज्ड समवेयर इन लॉट्स ऑफ केसेस, वेन एवर यू वॉन्ट टू डिस्प्ले द डेटा इन टू द प्रॉपर मैनर, एट दैट टाइम दिस मेथड्स आर हाईली यूज, अपर, लोअर, स्वैप केस, कैपिटलाइज, टाइटल, ओके. अगेन दिस वन डिपेंड्स ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज, नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट, ओके, नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट वेदर माई स्ट्रिंग इज अल्फाबेट्स, वेदर माई स्ट्रिंग इज अल्फा न्यूमेरिक, वेदर माई स्ट्रिंग इज, यू नो, द डिजिट्स, और इट्स ए स्पेस, स्पेस, ओके. सो दैट इज माई रिक्वायरमेंट दैट आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट. सो फॉर द सेम वी हैव अनदर मेथड्स विच आर अवेलेबल इन साइड दिस पाइथन. सो लेट सपोज योर स्ट्रिंग इज दिस वन, ए जेड, ओके, ए जेड पी पी पी. सो वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस, ओके, वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस. नाउ दिस स्ट्रिंग इज माई, यू नो, द स्ट्रिंग इज माई अल्फाबेट्स, ओके, अल्फाबेट्स, अल्फाबेट्स मीन द स्ट्रिंग कंटेन ओनली अल्फाबेट्स, नथिंग एल्स, ओके, द स्ट्रिंग कंटेन्स ओनली अल्फाबेट, नथिंग एल्स. सो आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट वेदर आई एम गेटिंग ए डेटा फ्रॉम समवेयर, एंड आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट वेदर दिस डेटा कंटेन्स ओनली अल्फाबेट्स और नॉट, ओके, ओनली अल्फाबेट्स और नॉट. देन हाउ आई कैन चेक इट आउट, एक्स डॉट इज अल्फा, ओके, एक्स डॉट इज अल्फा, इज अल्फा इज ए मेथड, वेरी सिंपल इंग्लिश टर्मिनोलॉजी, इज अल्फा, ओके, इज अल्फा इज ए मेथड, दैट्स मीन अल्फाबेट्स, इज अल्फा इज ए मेथड विच विल रिटर्न यू ट्रू इफ द एंटायर स्ट्रिंग कंटेन्स द डेटा फ्रॉम ए टू जेड, स्मॉल ए टू जेड, और फ्रॉम कैपिटल ए टू जेड, ओके, दैट डजेंट मैटर, द स्मॉल ए टू जेड और कैपिटल ए टू जेड, इफ द स्ट्रिंग कंटेन ओनली दीज करेक्टर्स, देन इट विल रिटर्न यू द आउटपुट दैट इज द ट्रू, ओके, दैट इज द ट्रू, ओके. सो नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट वेदर माई स्ट्रिंग इज इन अपर केस और नॉट, इज अपर, ओके, इज अपर. सो आउटपुट अगेन यू विल गेट द ट्रू बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज इन टू द अपर केस, ओके. सो दिस वन इज आई एम आस्किंग ए क्वेश्चन टू ए स्ट्रिंग, इज अपर, इज अल्फा, ओके. लेट सपोज द स्ट्रिंग कंटेन्स ओनली डिजिट्स एंड आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट वेदर द स्ट्रिंग कंटेन ओनली डिजिट्स और नॉट, ओके. सो हाउ आई कैन चेक इट आउट, एक्स डॉट इज डिजिट, ओके, एक्स डॉट इज डिजिट. नाउ द आउटपुट इज ट्रू, नाउ द आउटपुट इज ट्रू. वाई सो? बिकॉज द स्ट्रिंग कंटेन ओनली डिजिट. लेट सपोज इट कंटेन समथिंग एल्स, इट कंटेनिंग ऑल्सो एस, ओके, ऑल्सो एस, देन द आउटपुट वुड बी, देन द आउटपुट वुड बी फॉल्स बिकॉज दिस स्ट्रिंग डजेंट कंटेन ऑल द करेक्टर डेटा स्ट्रिंग. Here the some are the special, some are the, you know, the alphabets also containing into this string. So that's why this method is returning you false. Okay, very simple terminologies, similar like to English one. So now this case is alphanumeric. Okay, alphanumeric. So for the alphanumeric, how I can check it out, is the alphanumeric or not? X dot is alpha. Okay, is alpha. What is the meaning of is alpha? Is, I think the spelling is mistake, is alpha. What is the meaning of the is alpha? If the string contain capital A to Z, small a to Z, and 0 to 9. If the string contains capital A to Z, small a to Z, and 0 to 9, at that time, if I perform the method, that method is called is alpha. Okay, then the output would be true. So I think it's giving me the false output because why it's giving me the false output? I don't know. Why it's giving the false? Is alpha. Sorry, not is alpha. Is alpha num. I'm sorry. Is alpha num. Okay, alpha num. So it's not a method. Let me check the spellings. Is alpha num. Not is alpha num. The method name is called all num. All num. Yes, this one is a method. I am sorry for the same. Is alpha alpha num. You are not supposed to write something like this. The method name is into the shortcut way. Is all num. It's mean. Let me write over here. It's mean. If my string contain A to Z, that's a capital A to Z, small A to Z, okay, small A to Z, then 0 to 9. If string contain the combination of all these, okay, then the output would be true. Output would be true. Okay, so I want to check it out whether my string is alpha num or not. But keep this point in mind. Here is some tricky logic is there. So here I say it. If my string contain A to Z, if my string contain capital A to Z, okay. If now let's suppose I write this A S D E and capital R. Okay, so I write this. Now if I again perform this method, so it will again give me the true. Because why so? Because I am writing over here, because this is the method works something like this. If the string contain any of these, then output will always true. In the case of is alpha, okay, in the case of is alpha, it's again going me the true output. Is alpha, okay, it's again give me the true output, A-L-P-H-A, okay, it's again giving me the true output. In the both of the cases that you will get the true output, but this method is specially meant for check it out whether the string contain A to Z or capital A to Z or 0 to 9. If it is combination of all, then again the output of true. It is just A to Z capital, then again the output true. If it is small a to Z, then again the output true. But in the case of alpha, it should be give me the output true only in the case of when the string contain only A to Z small or A to Z capital. So keep this point into the mind. Okay, so it will return me the output in the case of that when the string contain only capital A to Z or small a to Z. Whenever the string contains something like this, let's suppose A, B, C, X and 5, 6. Now this time, if I perform the method is alpha, then the output is become false. So keep this point into the mind. So this method works something like this. Okay, because here the terminology is there, any of these. But here the terminology is any of these two. Okay, here any of these three. Here any of these two. So keep this point into the mind. Now, I want to check it out. If the string contain empty string. Okay, that's mean it's contain only space. It's contain only space, then how I can check it out? X dot is space. Okay, X dot is space. Then the output would be true. If the string contains only space, the meaning of the only space, it doesn't contain anything. Let's suppose this time it contains spaces as well. Okay, and character as well. And I want to check it out. Now it will give you the false. So a space will work only then when your string contains only spaces, nothing else. Okay. So this one is the method which are highly used with this string. Okay, there are further methods, there are again some methods which are left out. You can check it out and try by your own. Okay, but I show you all those methods which are highly used.